the Global Dressage Forum North America, the ultimate educational experience where champions meet.
DressageClinic.com. A world of knowledge at your fingertips.
And so, ladies and gentlemen, for a very special presentation, I'm going to welcome onto the stage now Noreen O'Sullivan, COO of Wellington Classic Dressage, and Andrea Stano, the Executive Director of DressageClinic.com and founder and producer of Global Dressage Forum North America. Ladies and gentlemen, Noreen O'Sullivan and Andrea Stano.
Hello. Once again, I'd like to thank everyone for coming tonight. We hope you've been having a fabulous time here, and we are so proud to be hosting this first annual Global Dressage Forum. Another very special thing tonight is we are going to do our first Lifetime Achievement Award to Mr. Klaus Balkenhol. And on behalf of myself with Wellington Classic Dressage and Andreas with DressageClinic.com, we're very happy to be here to present this special award.
Thank you, Noreen. The spotlight now turns to our Global Dressage Forum North America Lifetime Dressage Achievement Award. This award has been created to recognize individuals who have not only dedicated their lives to dressage with a history of success, but those who have also dedicated themselves to dressage education for North America. Klaus Balkenhol has put a landmark in all our lives as dressage riders. On stage, we would also like to present Mr. Stefan Peters later on and Mr. George Williams of the United States Dressage Federation to join us. And we have asked a very talented film producer in Germany, Roland Bloom, to prepare for us a short video clip on the life and times of Klaus Balkenhol. May we have the video, please?
Klaus Balkenhol und Goldstern. Mein Name ist Klaus Balkenhol, ist der amtierende deutsche Meister und Titelverteidiger. 1992 in Barcelona mit der Mannschaft Olympiasieger und die Bronzemedaille im Einzel. Mannschaftsweltmeister und Vize-Weltmeister in den A2-Reiterspielen.
With their all-round trained horses, riders in uniform held sway for decades in the tournament arenas of the world. Once the cavalry disappeared in most countries, however, officers were no longer to be found in the dressage ring. Dressage was a building block of horse training and military service for hundreds of years. In Germany, the basis of this training for rider and horse was the Heeresdienstvorschrift, Army Service Regulation, or HDV-12 for short, which was issued in 1912. Under the shadow of war in his youth, this farmyard was a relative haven for young Klaus and his family.
When one grows up like I did, on a farm where there were lots of children, you learn from early on to get along with each other.
Aber auch auf einem Bauernhof nach der alten Art.
It was also a farm run in the old way, that is, with all of the animals one could imagine on the farm, whether they were rabbits, pigeons, pigs, cows, horses, sheep, and everything else that really belongs in the farmyard. It was a blessing that you could learn to respect the animals, all kinds of animals. But then afterwards, you always had the horse as a companion in the work. The daily work in the fields in the 1950s, or the beginning of the 1950s, was always done with the horse. So all of these things, in fact, very closely connected with the horses and the men living on the farm and the family. When I joined the police, I didn't really know too much about the mounted police. I knew that they existed, but not how they worked with the horse, what there was to do, and so on and so on. That was actually all not so clear to me until I decided to go and sign up for the mounted police. The self-evident attitude of horses was just there from my youth. There was no shyness. One just sat on the horse and, of course, did other things. We weren't thinking about a Grand Prix in the beginning. This was just the workhorse for the police.
A colleague from the mounted squad also takes care of Goldstern at the Olympics in Atlanta. Trusted reference persons in strange environments are especially important. And the service steed, Goldstern, is a member of the family. As Klaus Balkenhol always says, a lifetime as a rider is not enough to experience and understand riding to its very depths. That was never a question for him. Harry Bolt, his predecessor as national trainer, also achieved everything as a rider and a trainer at the Olympics and championships. Klaus Balkenhol highly esteems his advice. The relationship with Brentina and Debbie McDonald has a long and successful history. Even as a young horse, he was actively involved in her training and accompanied her on her path to success. Team Silver at the World Equestrian Games in 2002 in Jerez de la Frontera, Spain. 2003, she won the World Cup. And 2004, the Olympic team bronze medal in Athens. These are the most important highlights of her career.
Oh, Klaus is the heart and soul of the team. That's what Klaus is. I think because his sensitivity and kindness to the horses, that's the way I like to train. I love to know that we have a relationship, and I see that in Klaus, and he's so sincere about how he loves the animals.
He influenced your riding if you look back in the past.
I think because of him, we've been successful. He chose the right shows in the beginning for Brentina to get her name out there. He's had a big part of that mare's career, and I thank him for that.
It is very important to Klaus Balkenhol to maintain and encourage a lively team spirit. Riding well is always a team sport, even when the partnership with a horse encompasses two totally different worlds.
And what's the role that Klaus Balkenhol has played?
Well, this quiet method of working the horse has done a lot of good. He does not allow any tension to present itself. My horse has temperament and is sensitive, and so this manner of training from Mr. Balkenhol is exactly what my horse needs.
Very good.
It is very easy for me to work with him. I have to say that we are always on the same wavelength, and clearly he has a very beautiful eye. And additionally, if I am doubtful, he can make the point by taking control and showing me how it is supposed to be done. Naturally, that's a huge plus.
So now let's practice a little bit. Exactly. That was correct. Now bring him back very decidedly into the piaf, and then light. Good, good, good. Good. Yes, Günther.
Jawohl. So.
Let him take 12, 13, up to 15 piaf steps. That is very good.
Good riding becomes an experience characterized by harmony. Dressage riding is not a purpose unto itself. It is the precondition for a safe and obedient horse, for safe and enjoyable riding in the fields. Klaus Balkenhol has never lost that multifaceted approach to a good riding horse. All his dressage specialists are happy about their rides, and for Klaus Balkenhol, they are a source of the harmony along with the horse.
Klaus Balkenhol is unique because he believes in dressage education. In 2002, when I had the idea of creating an educational system on the internet, which was revolutionary at that time, and before I had even begun it, I didn't know who to turn to for support. I decided to turn to Klaus Balkenhol. He didn't know me. I didn't know him. I just called him. And on that phone call, I explained to him my idea of providing a system on the internet where dressage riders around the world could benefit. And what makes Klaus Balkenhol so special is because he had the vision and he had the interest for dressage education for the masses around the world. On that phone call, he didn't believe in me. He believed in the idea. And the idea was education for the entire world. He decided to support me. And ever since then, dressageclinic.com has provided dressage education to over 23 countries around the world. And thousands have benefited from this system because this man had the vision. I would like now to invite the President of the United States Dressage Federation, Mr. George Williams, and our mentor and friend, Mr. Stefan Peters. Stefan, would you give us a few words?
Klaus, so many of us have seen you compete. A lot of us had the chance to work with you as a coach, as a trainer. I feel very honored that some of us actually were included in your circle of friends. I feel very honored about this. What a lot of people might know not about you is the fact that you're an amazing ambassador for the fairness of the horse. True horsemanship. And so many people talk about this and think they're the same way. You always back it up with actions. I remember one situation where you told a rider to get off the horse because the horse was not treated correctly. It was punished. You made a point walking up to the rider and say, look, this is enough. And I feel the actions speak, not just words. I feel honored that I get a chance to represent what we all think about you, and I'm honored to share this wonderful award that we have provided for you tonight. Congratulations.
Mr. George Williams of the USDF.
Klaus, I have so many great memories of the years that I had, the few years I had working with you with Roche. Your family was so welcoming when we came to Germany. The camaraderie that was developed in your stable, the ping pong games that we played, and all the things that we did that sort of really brought us all together. I'm not sure if everyone is aware that of that side of you and the fun that we had. The memories of working with you and being trained by you are terrific. But I think just sitting there and watching you as a horseman and the lessons that you gave, and as Stefan mentioned, the way you treated the horses, the fairness to the horses, the overall attitude, I would say you were a true horseman. And I don't think there are that many true horsemen around, and you were certainly one of them. I do have to say, though, that one of my least favorite memories is trying to keep up with you on the Audubon when we're following you. I, like Stefan, I also am very honored to be part of this. You are very deserving of this award. I think what you have done for a number of the U.S. riders, Stefan, Gunther, the ones that we saw on the video, was just outstanding, and the impact that it's had on this country has been great. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Klaus Balkenhol and Judith Balkenhol. Yeah. We'll give this to Klaus to hold. We'll put him in the middle. We'll give this to... Is this heavy for you?
No.
Yeah. And it's got engraving.
Okay. Thank you.
Klaus. Sir, it's a pleasure. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Klaus Balkenhol, Judith Balkenhol, Stefan Peters, George Williams, Norino Sullivan, thank you. I would like to invite all our clinicians, all our panelists to come and join us for this great moment. Yes. Good.
So. Also, mein Englisch ist nicht so gut. My language is bad. And I have on my side Stefan, and he is the translator for me this evening. Stefan, es ist so ein emotionaler Moment für uns beide. Wir lieben natürlich Amerika. Wir finden hier ein zweites Zuhause.
Klaus mentioned it is such an emotional and important evening. America is almost the second home to both Judith and Klaus, and I feel very grateful to be here tonight.
Ich möchte es nicht unterlassen, Dank zu sagen. In so einem Moment muss man daran denken, wem man diese emotionale Stunde zu verdanken hat.
Klaus would like to mention a few names because he'd like to be very thankful to very specific people.
Also bedanken möchte ich mich natürlich auch bei Andreas, der hier ein wunderschönen Event gemacht hat.
Many thanks to Andreas, who provided an amazing environment and event for us tonight.
Auch denen zu danken, die nun dazu beigetragen haben, dass das zustande kam, mit so tollen Referenten. Das ist also schon eine Seltenheit und es, glaube ich, schon 20 Jahre zu spät für Amerika, dass sowas stattfindet.
Klaus would like to thank also Andreas' support staff, all the people who made this event happen. And Klaus thinks that it's actually 20 years too late that we started this.
Bedanken möchte ich mich aber bei einem Begleiter, der in den Anfängen die Lehrgänge, die ich gemacht habe, die Seminare hier in Amerika, ein Übersetzer, das ist Folly Braumann, der auch hier ist. Aber steh ruhig mal auf, Folly, damit man dich sieht.
Folly.
Es war schon toll.
Also many thanks to Volker Braumann, who's been a long-time friend of Judith and Klaus, a long-time supporter.
Bedanken möchte ich mich aber bei dem Team, bei allen Reitern, mit denen ich zusammengearbeitet habe. Es hat mir sehr viel Spaß gemacht. Ich habe sehr viel dabei lernen können.
Many thanks also to the members of the equestrian teams that Klaus coached. And Klaus said he learned a lot himself being involved with the U.S. team.
Eine große Unterstützung fand ich durch Ellen und Bruce Miller in den Anfängen.
Many thanks to the support through Helen and Bruce Miller.
Da möchte ich daran erinnern an Tony und Dave Page.
I'm sorry?
Tony und Dave Page.
Tony and Dave Page, certainly big supporters.
An die wunderbaren Florida Parties.
Many, I don't even have to translate that, Klaus, that's good. Everybody got this.
Mit dicken Zigarren und Portwein, es war wunderbar.
He still remembers Dave's cigars and the amazing wine on many parties.
Ich möchte mich aber auch bei Linda und Keith Wolten in Kalifornien bedanken, bei denen wir auch immer wunderbare Tage und wo wir wohnen konnten, ohne dass nun USAF etwas bezahlen musste.
Many thanks to Keith and Linda Wolten in California, where the U.S. Clinics were held. They felt always very welcome, never charged the U.S. or Klaus and Judith a penny for it.
Aber mein besonderen Dank gilt Mary Ann und Walter McPhail, bei denen wir immer wieder ein Zuhause gefunden haben, so wie auch heute. Das war selbstverständlich, dass wir wieder dort wohnen konnten, wo wir also viele Jahre eine wunderschöne Wohnung hatten.
Many thanks to Mary Ann and Walter McPhail, who became wonderful friends and are still every single time very, very hospitable.
Und zuletzt möchte ich mich bei Ihnen bedanken, die sich also hier zusammengefunden haben und mit mir nun diese emotionale Stunde erleben. Vielen, vielen Dank.
Many thanks to you, all of you who learned to celebrate this wonderful hour with us.
Thank you to a great man. Yeah, good. We thank you everyone for joining us for this very special moment. And now we will continue our program.
And once again, a reminder that Klaus will be signing.
The Global Dressage Forum North America, the ultimate educational experience where champions meet.
DressageClinic.com. A world of knowledge at your fingertips.